This video focuses on useful extensions for Stable Diffusion. We'll start with the Image Browser extension, which allows you to easily access the prompts and settings used for any generated image. So first you have to go to the Extension tab, click on Load. Here you can see a list of extensions that you can install. For now, let's search for Image Browser. This is the one. Go ahead and click on Install. After installation, restart your UI, go to Settings, Reload UI. Next, click on Image Browser, click on First Page, and here you can see all the images that I have previously generated. By selecting an image, you can view the specific details of its generation. This includes the prompt, the sampler, the model used, and all the other settings that were used to create this image. You also have the option to send your image to Text-to-Image tab by clicking here. So here you can see all the settings that I used are right here. I'm gonna use a random seed to make a similar looking image. You can also send the image to Image-to-Image tab or to InFaint or to Extras for upscaling. Now let's move on to the next extension. It is Aspect Ratio Helper. Go ahead and install it. We're gonna restart our UI. Down here, you can see various buttons that you can select to resize your image. I'm gonna load my prompts. Select the square ratio 1:1 and click on generate. So all the images generated, as you can see, are in the square format. Now let's generate some portraits. I'm gonna switch the height and width. And here you can see, we have portraits. So you might have been wondering how I got four different images from the same prompt. All the letters that you see, which have underscores, they are what we call a wildcard. This is done with an extension called Dynamic Prompts. So I'm gonna show you how it's done. You can download it the same way we did before. After you have installed the extension, you need to download the wildcard files. Go to this link and copy this. Go to your extension folder. As the dynamic prompts, do a git bash here and clone the repository. Once you cloned it, you can find all the files needed for your wildcards to work. Go ahead and move them to the wildcard folder. When you reload your UI, you're gonna see all these wildcards right here. Each one of these is a file containing different values. When you use it in a prompt, as you can see, actress, background, and camera is gonna select a different word every generation. So I'm gonna click on generate. Here you can see four different types of images generated from the same prompt. It's gonna pick an actress, background, and camera at random. This really helps you when you wanna try out different prompts and see what they generate. The next extension I'm gonna talk to you about is Boru Tag Autocompletion. Like its name implies, it's basically a autocomplete for a tag. So when you type in your prompts, you can see the various autocomplete options. You can select one of those. You can also see the popularity of the tag. It also works with the dynamic prompt extension. So when you type in two underscores, you can see all the dynamic prompts as well. It makes it very easy to type in your prompts. Like you see here in my negative prompts, when I type in low or bad, you can see the various autocomplete tags. You can check out their GitHub page for more info. I hope you guys found this video about Stable Diffusion extensions really helpful. If you want to see more videos about Stable Diffusion, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys next time.